Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Portrait Journeys with Da Vinci. Hello, fellow art enthusiasts. I am Leonardo da Vinci, your eternal companion on this artistic voyage through portraiture. In our recent odyssey, we marveled at the brushstrokes of Peter Paul Rubens, a luminary whose artistry illuminated the canvases of the Baroque era. Today, our journey takes an exciting turn, leading us to explore the dynamic and expressive world of Frans Hals, a masterful painter from the Dutch Golden Age. Hals' unconventional approach to capturing the essence of his subjects, infused with vitality and movement, redefined portraiture, elevating it to a new level of artistic expression. One of his masterpieces, the lively Laughing Cavalier, stands as a testament to his artistic brilliance. Join us on this artistic expedition through Frans Hals' gallery, where his loose, painterly brushwork invites us to witness the vibrant pulse of an era. Frans Hals was born in Antwerp, in the Spanish Netherlands, to cloth merchant François Frans Hals van Mechelen and Adriëntje van Geertenrijk. Fleeing the fall of Antwerp, Hals' parents sought refuge in Haarlem, in the new Dutch Republic, where he spent the entirety of his life. Under the tutelage of Flemish émigré Karel van Mander, Hals honed his artistic skills, though Mander's mannerist influence is subtly perceptible in Hals's work. Joining the Haarlem Guild of St. Luke, Hals ventured into art restoration for the town council, marking the beginning of his artistic journey. Hals played a pivotal role in the evolution of 17th century group portraiture, with his breakthrough moment being the creation of the life-size group portrait titled The Banquet of the Officers of the St. George Militia Company. While contemporaries such as Rembrandt moved their households according to the caprices of their patrons, but Hals remained in Haarlem and insisted that his customers come to him. For this reason, we can assume that all sitters were either from Haarlem or were visiting Haarlem when they had their portraits made. His diverse portfolio depicted various strata of society: banquets, meetings of officers, guildsmen, local councilmen, itinerant players, singers, gentlemen, fishwives, and tavern heroes. Hals's preference for daylight and silvery sheen, contrasting with Rembrandt's golden glow effects, showcased his rare intuition in capturing moments with fluid strokes. Celebrated for his distinctive style during the Dutch Golden Age, Frans Hals showcased a portrait painting technique that set him apart from contemporaries like Rembrandt or Velázquez. While he may not have delved as deeply into psychological insight as these masters, Hals's works occasionally unveiled a profound analysis of character, distinguishing them from the instantaneous expressions found in his character portraits. His mastery lay in a technique that ingeniously transformed what was once considered a flaw, the visible brushstroke, into a defining feature. The soft, curling lines of Hals's brush consistently manifested on the surface, lying materially flat while evoking substance and space. Although Hals sometimes painted without underdrawings, a la prima, most of his works were created in successive layers, customary for the time. His underpainting, often applied loosely, showcased his virtuosity from the beginning, especially prominent in his genre works and later mature pieces. Hals demonstrated daring, courage, and virtuosity, pulling back his hands at the most impactful moments, avoiding overworking his paintings, a practice in contrast to many of his meticulous contemporaries. In matters of style, paintings attributed to Judith Leister, frequently bearing her signature, bore a striking resemblance to Hals's distinctive work. The possibility arises that Leister, alongside her husband Jan Mienzer Molinaer, may have been influenced as a student of Hals. Hals's artistic journey witnessed a shift in style over the years. Vibrant, colorful paintings gradually gave way to compositions dominated by black, likely influenced by the sober dress of his Protestant sitters. In his later years, brushstrokes became looser, emphasizing overall impressions over fine details. Early works radiated gaiety and liveliness, while later portraits focused on the stature and dignity of the subjects. A virtuoso in capturing the essence of joyous unions, Frans Hals, with his unparalleled mastery, undertook a multitude of commissions for wedding portraits. These canvases, rich in opulence and emotional resonance, stand as testaments to Hals's ability to infuse celebratory moments with life. Steering away from conventional stiffness, Hals orchestrated a symphony of color, movement, and sentiment in each matrimonial masterpiece. Guided by tradition, he skillfully positioned the husband on the left and the wife on the right. Yet within this framework, Hals spun a narrative of shared laughter, whispered promises, and the timeless beauty of love immortalized on canvas. In these wedding portraits, Hals didn't merely paint faces. He encapsulated the very spirit of matrimony, breathing vitality into every stroke and creating visual love stories that transcend time. Let us now delve into Frans Hals's masterpiece, The Laughing Cavalier. This lively composition defies convention with spontaneous brushstrokes, unveiling the artist's swift technique. The intricate details of the exquisite silk costume accentuate the turning pose, highlighting the adorned embroidered sleeve and lace cuff. These aren't just details, they bear emblems symbolizing the pleasures and pains of love: bees, arrows, flaming cornucopiae, lovers' knots, and tongues of fire. Together, they infuse depth into this joyous portrayal. As your gaze meets the eyes of the laughing cavalier, witness the captivating effect. Those eyes seemingly follow you from every angle. Hals achieves this dynamic engagement by portraying the subject looking directly forward, creating an illusion of movement within the static, two-dimensional canvas. Frans Hals's masterpieces continue to captivate, serving as invaluable lessons for painters who seek insight from his bold and expressive brushstrokes. Numerous significant works by Frans Hals find a home at the Frans Hals Museum, proudly displayed by the Town Council of Haarlem. If this exploration has ignited your curiosity and appreciation, consider subscribing to our channel. Your subscription ensures you won't miss upcoming episodes where we delve into the mysteries behind more captivating portraits. See you in the next episodes of Portrait Journeys with Da Vinci, and always remember, art will never die.